So today I want to show you how we can implement the orbit animation but including rotation. I have already prepared my project. You can check the configuration and how to step by step prepare such a project in my previous videos. So let's focus quickly on what we have here. So we have a window style volumetric, and the size of the cube is 2 meters on each side. So keep in mind that if we use the volumetric window style, we also need to include this information inside our info configuration file. Otherwise, the app will crash. Okay. So basically what is going on here is that we are loading our USDZ file, which is just a dragon 3D model with some animation. We position this entity, we put our dragon into this new created entity for the purpose of orbit animation, and it will orbit in a duration of 5 seconds in axis coordinates. So let's do not wait anymore, and I can show you how it looks like. Okay, so as you can see, the dragon is indeed perform an animation, and also it orbits in the center of the scene. But it looks strange that it doesn't spin around this orbit. So how can we do this in RealityKit? So first of all, we can get what we can do is just implement the the default orientation. So like we want to have this dragon in appropriate starting point, and we need a update callback from RealityView, which will be performing a spin animation. And about the spin animation, first we need to get to our dragon. So from our entity, we will fetch just there is one children inside, so this is our 3D model. And what is going on here is that we use a move function which takes a transform, and transform has this nice initializer with each rotation axis. So in our example, yaw is an axis coordinate. Of course, it will spin around, so it will be relative to the model itself, so to the dragon. Duration will be the same as the orbit animation, and we do not touch timing function, it just be linear. So let's stop and rebuild and see how it will look like. Okay, so we see that the dragon started to rotate, but what is happening is that the orbit animation is an infinite, and we also saw that our rotation was only performed with minus pi number, and pi number in radians is in degrees is 180, but basically we are doing the whole circle. So we need to multiply it by 2, right? Because we want to have 360 degrees of rotation. So let's have a look. Okay, and that's strange. That's strange because our dragon is not spinning anymore, not even 180. So the issue is that the Apple RealityKit rotation is like limited to 180, and if you increase this number by anyhow, the whole animation will just will be not performed at all. So that's the problem. How we can rotate it more than 180 if this function doesn't do it? Okay, so let's don't wait, and I can show you how we can bypass this issue. Okay, so for the sake of just a tutorial, I have two global variables here. So basically, that hack, that solution includes usage of combine, but it will be used only for the to perform animation each time when it is completed. So to start a new one, and animation playback will be our reference to the first animation. I will explain what means first animation. So the code here doesn't change at all. It's just, you know, a default orientation. That's fine. So here we have improved our perform spin function. So what we are doing here is we are moving the character, I mean the dragon, two times. But of course we are bounded to 180 degrees, so this is just one number pi, and here is another pi number. But we just assign the first one to our global variable animation playback. That means when we will set up the observers, we will cancel any upcoming events. We want to just subscribe to animation events playback completed. That's very important to type here playback completed. And we can focus only on the animation which are performed basically on our dragon. So and if animation playback is the same from the event, that means that our animation was performed, this one also, and we can do it again. Without it, the dragon will start to spin around and around many times, because we have like right now two animations going, and we only want to trigger again perform spin method when the first is completed and not the second one. Okay, so let's have a look. Right now it looks like this. Okay, so as you can see, now the dragon flies in good direction, and I think that looks much better than the first attempt. So if you want to know more about visionOS, please come to my YouTube channel, subscribe, and also check my website for any newsletter things and some mini courses. Thank you for your attention.